good, y'all? It's your boy LC Aquatics back here with another video. So today we are at the OCC Aquarium. I'm giving you all a tour. But so the thing is, the audio might be a little weird. It might be a little echoey, so just be aware of that. But it's the best I can do since I don't want to refilm everything since it's kind of a hassle. So right now we are just chilling. We're in a white sea bass. So that's cool. And then, yeah, I got a little calico bass in there. And then we have the more eel tank, but yeah, that's just the beginning. So walking in directly to my left, you'll see a triceratops skull, which is freaking crazy. And then a whole ass allosaurus skeleton. Holy crap. Isn't that the coolest thing ever? Coming up next, we have the shoal tank. So with the shoal tank, tropical shoal, so we have one pufferfish, I think it's not a spotted puffer, but just I don't know what kind of puffer it is, but it's a pufferfish. And we got a triggerfish right there, if you can see him right there, adorable little shit. And then if you come over here, we can see that we have a jewel eel right there. Oh, guys, breathing, really cute. Yeah, this little guy, he's feisty, low-key, so whenever I'm feeding him, he's kind of, like, all over the place, but, yeah, let's go to the next tank. All right, next up, we have the mangrove tank. It houses one archerfish right there, really pretty, and then one monofish, and then there's a green-spotted puffer somewhere in here. I don't know where it is, but it's in there. And so it's basically, they grow mangroves right here. It's they also have a fogger to make it, but it's really humid for the mangroves. And then also they have a canister filter. So simple canister filter setup. So yeah, that's, oh, there's the green spotted puffer right there in the back. Yeah, right there. Really sick tank, by the way. Like, there's the archerfish. Feed that guy every once in a while, but it's really, really cool. So that's the whole setup. Next tank is a clownfish tank. Basically has three clownfish, bubble tip anemone, and then there's a conch right there. So three clownfish. It's a simple like back filter setup, and then a little light LED, and then there's a little coral banded shrimp right there. So that's really pretty. So yeah, that's that tank. So it's very beautiful, that clownfish. Next tank I'm going to show you is the cube tank with the doctor fish, or we call doctor loaches. I forgot exactly what they're called, but they're basically the, if you've seen like spawns in the past, like in China, like China and Japan, they're the ones that eat the dead skin off your feet. So yeah, it's basically just like a simple, a lot of anubias and like driftwood and stuff like that, and Java fern. It has like a simple hang on the back filter with an LED. And like, yeah, if I like stick my finger in there, they all like start eating the dead skin off. So like, yeah, right there, see it? Yeah, really pretty. It really tickles like a lot. So yeah, that's that tank. Let's move on to the next one. Alright, next tank is another aquascape. It's houses one blue acara. Really pretty fish. And then three albino pistos, or pistogrammas, or pistogrammies, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, just like a shit ton of rotala, like a crap ton. Yeah, and that's, yeah, there's one like Siamese algae eater in there, like right there. Yeah, it's packed in here. It's really packed. But yeah, that's that tank right there. Next tank is, this is like a blackwater quarantine tank. So anything that wants to live in like blackwater setup. So and so it just has like rosy barbs in here. And yeah, it's really, it's simple with like a hanging back filter LED light. All right, and this next tank is a betta tank, I think. I don't even know where the betta is. It might have died. We used to have a betta in here, but it had a really, really deformed spine. But like this tank for now, it's basically just, it's a African clawed frog, African dwarf frog, yeah. So it houses four African dwarf frogs. You can see them right there. They're hiding. Yeah, but we have four of them, and then it's like a simple hang on the back. I just hang on, not hang on the back filter, but just back filter, and so it'll flow. So yeah, that's that tank. All right, next tank on the board is Aquascape. Basically, a lot of houses, Harlequin Ras Boras. American flagfish or like Achilles fish right there. Which one is it? Oh, that's it right there. That one. Some mosey barbs. Yeah, it's really pretty aquascape. Yeah, it's just pretty simple. Otala, cribs. Yeah, a lot of black algae because there's a really big bacterial problem in here. So, yeah, it has a simple hanging hangover light, and then there's a filter in the. I think there's a sump. Not a sump, but a canister filter. So, yeah, it's a pretty cool setup, honestly. Well, for all you don't know, this is the lab I work in. So yeah, it's a really big lab. So now we're gonna start over here at the monster tank. So yeah, it houses two Asian arowanas, which were illegally they were caught illegally getting shipped to Mexico, and the Fish and Wildlife gave them to us. Yeah, and so now we have them. Since we're an educational facility, they gave it to us. And then there's giant gourami, and then there's a dinosaur bicher right there, the cutest little thing ever. So yeah, just curtains. There's a big, huge light on the top. And then, yeah, big old canister filter. Yeah, fluval, crazy. Yeah, it's super, like, seeing these fish every day. Like, I one time fed a grasshopper to this one. It destroyed it in a single gulp. Like, it was obviously took a few bites, but it still, like, was insane. And right here is coral propagation. So we basically just use different coral fragments and grow them in this tank. As you can see, like all these different coral we cut off. It houses a yellow tang, no tail, some tail problems, but it's all right. A black Acarus clownfish hanging on a bubble tip anemone, like a huge bubble tip anemone. And then I don't exactly know what this is called, but yeah, it's really huge. It has a big filtration system, like, right here. So, like, filter shock. And, like, they have the... this is, like, the algae part where it, like, oxidizes it. I don't even know what it does, but... Yeah, so they just have an AOT unit. ATO unit, sorry. I don't know why I said it. AOT. I'm not attacking a titan, but... Yeah, that just replaces... Since, like, when the water evaporates, the salinity goes up. And so what they use is fresh water to put that in, so the salinity stays the same, and so like they don't have a constant evaporation. So whenever a certain, like, let's say, like this is where the water is, right? Let's say it goes below this motor, this servo or whatever, the motor kicks up, pumps fresh water into that tank, so it keeps the salinity balanced. So that's why when people say they have an ATO unit, that means they just constantly are putting fresh water in the tank to keep the salinity the same. So that's how that works. Okay, so on to the next tank. This one's called Headlands. So this tank is a temp. It's supposed to be housed on a tempered system. It's really cold water. It houses one sheep's head, barred sand bass. Where is he? Right there, just chilling right there. We have a lobster in the corner up there. Say, what's that, bud? See, then there's another bass right there. If you just went around the corner. We have a flag rockfish. That one's really cool. And then. Yeah, I don't know what these ones are called, honestly, but yeah, they just grow some macroalgae here, some seaweed. Yeah, I think this one's artificial though, so. But yeah, she is a literal monster, seriously. Like, boys everyone on the tank. But yeah, that's that tank. Let's move on to the next one. So this next tank is the baby swell shark tank. So it houses one baby swell shark right there, if you can see him, or her. I don't even know what it is yet. They haven't said the gender, but yeah, we have one of our swell sharks gave birth not that long ago, and now we have a baby swell shark, so that's very cool. His name is Moomoo. See right there, Shark Moomoo. So that's cool. And coming up next is, we have a whole sea monkey acclimation thing. So we culture live sea monkeys right here in our facility to hand feed some of, not hand feed, but just feed some of our stuff healthy food. So we have that, then we have a whole another one like right here. We house Artemia, so like it's literally an insane setup. And to this setup, this is
coral frag. Yeah, this is a coral frag tank. We've just fragmentation, kind of like coral propagation, but it's not the same. Oh, this is also on the same ATO unit. Yeah, so we basically just fragmentate different corals. Fish and lilac give us some. We fragment here, and we also, it houses one clownfish in there. Just like, yeah, chilling with the other corals. Yeah, it's insane. Yeah, so that's that tank right there.
Right here we house one octopus. Right there in the back. Right there, if we see him chilling. Yeah, not a blue winged octopus, but I think it's a common octopus. I forgot what the exact one is, but that's our octopus right there. He's just,
we have him under a towel right now just because he's stressed. So we keep him under there for now. So in this tank right here is kelp forest. So this basically houses a calico bass right there, calico bass. And just grows kelp in here. And they also have a senorita rasp. And so this is our huge temperate system used for this tank, that tank, and the shark tank outside. I haven't got to that one yet, but I will in a little bit, because there's people out there feeding it, and I don't want to go out there while they're filming. I mean, not they're filming, after they feed it. So yeah, so huge temperate system. It starts out in this giant pipe, goes down this big giant filter pad. We call this one Big Blue. It filters half the water, and then it goes to this UV sterilizer, kills up all the bad bacteria and algae or whatever. Then it goes into this huge 800-gallon sump, and like, yeah, it's massive under here. Like, it's huge. And then it goes through there, and then it goes through to this really big, what's it called?
Water enters this system from the sump here through that pipe. It gets pulled through this bronze pump, which brings water into this sand filter here. This is not a traditional sand filter. I don't remember what this is called. This is not part of the protein skimmer. This is just something else. But water goes up here and then out of this siphon through, I mean, it's not a siphon, but it is a pipe that uses a siphon that brings water down here into this. This is the contact chamber. A contact chamber is where the water goes and it meets air. And when it meets air, that is how the proteins are stripped from the water. So, next thing we have is this. This is an air pump that is bringing air into this system here, and this is called a venturi. The venturi also adds air to the system because it has a differentiating, it has like, here's how I explain it. It's got pressure differences inside the this chamber here. There is an open side and then a closed middle and an open end. And there's low pressure here and high pressure here, and then low pressure on the other side as well. So once you get high pressure here, wait, my bad. Let's backtrack a little bit. This pump does not suck air into it. This just removes water and puts it back into the system. What happens here is you have this, and this is sucking air into the system. Do you see how it is an air pressure gauge right there? Well, if you put your finger on the back of this, come around. So this is pulling air into the venturi. You have your area of pressure difference, which sucks air into it. And I see. So there's water in here, and that is sucking air and infusing the air into the water, which adds bubbles into this chamber. The bubbles are stripping the hydrophobic compounds from the water, which then rise up this central column and they overflow and spill out into the collection cup. And then we have some pore sap clean this out like once a day. And it smells.
All right, our next tank is riparium. So riparium, we have some rainbow fish, We have a few Buenos Aires tetras in there. We have there's a sturble quarry in here somewhere. I don't know where exactly it is, but there's a quarry in here. Yeah, I don't know where, but yeah, but there's a Chinese golden alligator somewhere also. You know, a catfish in there as well. Yeah, a few clown loaches right there. And also the Hawaiian golden pothos growing out of it. And then the filtration system. We have a tube coming from the bottom, going into these filter media. Then it goes through the sump, it goes out this pump, goes through there, and then filters back in through there. And then we also have some Java ferns. So that's really cool. And yeah, oh, there's that golden pick I was talking about right in the back. But yeah, that's this tank. A very, very cool tank, actually. There's a big, simple, just light up top. Keep them from growing. And yeah. All right, this is our shark tank. It houses 5 horn sharks with a swell shark. See that swell shark? See, hey, girl, how you doing? Yeah, 5 male horn sharks. There's also not a zebra, what the fuck am I saying? Leopard shark, right there. Swimming away from me. Oh my God. And there's an opali. Opalis, there, right there, opali. 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 It's an opali. Shun dance that tank. Yeah, this is also part of the temperature system in there, if you see it. Oh, I also forgot to fill this tank out. This is a filter feeding tank. This is, yeah, just a bunch of filters. It's not my favorite. I hate it, actually. It's the worst. But yeah, this is the freaking shark tank. So cool. Yeah, for this tank, I'm just doing a voiceover. So this is called Drop Comp. And so it just has like a bunch of anemones and other stuff. Like there's a cardinal fish in there. There's a cockfish. There's a tomato clown. There's some wrasse. I don't exactly remember what some of them were called, but there's some bubble tips in there, some rock spawn. Yeah, like, yeah, it's really cool. I like it a lot. One of my favorite tanks that we have. Yo, what is up, guys? Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and always hit the bell. Peace out.